In this video, we're going to cover how to create a new assignment in your course site. So I'm going to navigate to the assignment section of the course site right here. So I'll select assignments. And then by default, we have just one assignment group. You can create additional assignment groups right here. But for now, let's just focus on creating that first assignment. So I'm going to hit plus assignment right here. And I'll type in a title here. And then right here in this text box, you can put in a description for the assignment, any essential information that you want students to know, instructions, file formats, anything like that can go in this box right here. So I've already typed that up. I'm just gonna copy and paste it in here for the student's reference, okay? Let's go down here to the options for your assignment. Now, right here, this first box, it's asking you how many points you want the assignment to be worth. And bCourses calculates grades based on a point system, gives you a final percentage for the grade. So really important to put in a point value there. So you can change this to 1 point, 100 points, whatever you want. Let's say for this essay, it's going to be 50 points. Okay. Assignment group, this next box right here. Right now, we just have one assignment group. But you can create as many assignment groups as you like. So you can change that there if you like. Display grade as. You have a number of options here. You can display it as a percentage, a letter grade, or you can choose not graded. A bit of a warning about the letter grade option. If you choose this, once again, I'm going to reiterate, you have to put in a point value up here. Sometimes instructors will put in a letter grade here and they forget to put in a point value, and that can cause some issues when they add a point value later. So just be sure that even if you're putting in the letter grade, you're adding a point value for your assignment. I'm going to go back to the points right here. That's the default. It works really well for the way I think about grades, so I'm going to leave that default. You have this option to not count this assignment towards the final grade. If you check that box, it's there in the gradebook, but it doesn't count towards the final grade. So this does exactly what it says it does. Let's go down to submission type. Right here, it's set to online. You also have the option for no submission. So a no submission assignment is perhaps students were getting points, participation points in class, and you were marking that down on a different piece of paper. So you want to put that into the gradebook, but the students are not actually submitting anything. Another option is on paper. So if students handed you a sheet of paper in class and you have all those papers, then you could put on paper, grade those papers, and then enter those scores into the gradebook. But most likely, you're going to choose online. And what this means is that the student is submitting some type of assignment through bCourses. So you have the option for a text entry right here, and then they would just be typing directly into a window on the assignment page. You can do a website URL. If they've created, let's say, a website for a project or something, they can submit a URL. Media recording, if they're going to upload or record a video as their assignment, that you would want to check that box. And then you have student annotation. In this scenario, you would be uploading a file that then the students would be annotating, and that would be their assignment, is the annotation work they did on that file that you upload. And then you have probably the most popular option, which is a file upload. So they can upload a PDF or a Word document. They can attach a Google Doc. If you do check this restrict upload file types, let's say you put in the DOCX format and PDF, those are like the most common formats. This does restrict students from uploading or attaching a Google Drive or Google Doc. So the feature is there if you want to put in those restrictions and prevent students from uploading the wrong file type. But note that you can't put in those Google Docs. I'm going to uncheck this, and I'm just going to rely on my description up here to upload a Microsoft Word or PDF. Okay. We check file uploads here. Submission attempts, this is exactly what you think it is. This allows you to choose the number of attempts that students can submit. I'm going to leave this at unlimited. So if you choose group assignment right here, it's going to ask you to pick a group or a group set. So members of that group only need one student to upload the assignment, and that assignment shows up for each student in that group. So one submission per group. You do have the option to assign grades to each student individually if you need to. Peer reviews, if you'd like students to review work of their peers before you give them a grade, you can check this box. The feature where you can assign a peer review randomly is very quick. If you have a large class and you're assigning those peer reviews manually, that can take quite a bit of time. So just a word of caution there. Let's talk about the assign access. So by default, it's going to assign to everyone in the class. You do have the option to assign something to a particular roster if you have multiple rosters. For example, a discussion roster. If you wanted to assign to just one discussion group, you could. And then you have right here the due date and the available from and until time. So you would put in your due date and then the available from and until is the window in which the student is permitted to submit that assignment. So if we put in a due date for January 15th, we could make it available to submit a week earlier and a week later. So let's do the 8th, and we can go to the 22nd, right? So it's due on the 15th, but they can submit as early as January 8th and as late as January 22nd. If they submit after this due date, the file will be marked as late, and then you have the option to add a late penalty in your settings for the gradebook. Now, if you would like to assign a different due date to an individual student or to a number of students, you can do that by selecting this option right here, plus assign to. So here I can assign it to an individual student, and I can give that student an extension. So I'll go to maybe January 17th. And that's a really handy feature because often there are exceptions to due dates. Okay, so notice how when I add this student in here, when I have a second assigned to window, this changes to everyone else. It no longer says everyone, it says everyone else because we've added this second assigned to date. All right, so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to hit this save and publish button. And that will take us back to the main page for that assignment. Here, this option right here, you can add a rubric. So for example, this is an essay assignment, so you might want to add a rubric onto that assignment. Once you've created that rubric, you can reuse it. And the rubric also shows up in the speed grader while you're grading, so that's a pretty handy feature. All right, so in the next video, we're going to talk about the discussion tool in bCourses.